Hey everybody, this is Matt Lewis with Hagerty, and today's DIY we're going to talk about wire gauge. Now, wire gauge is essentially a way in which they measure the size of the wire. The smaller the number, the larger the wire. So here, our black wire that we have on the table is a 4-gauge wire. It's very thick. Next to it, we have a red 10-gauge wire, then a blue 16, and a light blue 24. Now, they make all different gauges of wire because not everything needs this thick of a wire to operate. If you're running a small motor or something like that, probably get away with the 10 or maybe even the 16. But if you want to run a starter motor on your car, those pull a lot of current all of a sudden. So you've got to run a thick wire. You want to run the correct wire for the circuit because there's no need to run 4-gauge everywhere in your car. It's hard to work with, it's hard to crimp on, and it's expensive. So what you'll see is the car manufacturers will use the proper gauge for the circuit they're working with. If it's only about 10 amps of draw, something like this 16 would be just fine. You get into the very thin wire, like this 24, when you're working with a fuel sensor to tell you how full your fuel tank is. There's not a lot of current running through that sending unit. So what you end up with is a thin wire that's easy to work with, it's cheap to produce, and it does the job perfectly. When you get into something like a car stereo, that's closer to 10 or 15 amps, you're gonna wanna get into the 16 gauge or maybe even the 10 gauge wire to run that power. Because it's pulling more amperage through the wire, it needs to be thicker to handle that current draw. So this is a scenario that hopefully you will never encounter in your car. It's way too thin of a gauge wire, and there was no fuse whatsoever. Had there been a fuse, that would have popped before the wire melted. But without the fuse, the wire melts all of the housing, it can get red hot, and if this is running under the carpet of your car, it'll catch on fire. Bad stuff. So always be sure to use the right gauge wire for the circuit you're running. Well, hopefully our little explanation of wire gauge was helpful to you for the next project you work on. If you want to know about how big of a wire to work with what kind of a circuit, you can find that information on the internet. If you have questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below and subscribe to our channel to see the next one.